Hi everybody, I'm doing now this quick room. This is intro to log analysis. This is more about Linux command line, this one. So learning what we do this, an intro to log analysis best practice and essential tools to effective detection and response. So basically, so this room is set to learning objective, learn to log analysis best practice, discover the essential tools for log analysis, gain handling experience on multiple tools and technology. Okay, let's start. Log analysis basis. What is log? Log, of course, anything like, for example, this one is network activity. There is an alert. Anything we log in SIM. Anything else, like for example, here, of course, there's a time, the IP address, where it connect from, a source. Depend every type of the action, the source zone. Of course, you can read about this, why log important, of course important, system troubleshooting, cybersecurity incident, threat hunting, compliance, you need this for compliance, of course, legal requirement, types of log, of course, you have application, audit, security, server, system, network, database, web server, and anything else, it's a lot of logs, so in any case, So basically, whatever we can log in application, your phone will do log. So, several investigation theory, methodology, best practice and essential technique are implemented to create a coherent timeline and conduct effective log analysis investigation. Of course, we need a timeline, fundamental aspect when this is in sequence, timestamp, of course, any log need to have a time on it. Super timeline, what that is super timeline, also known as consolidated timeline, as it is a powerful concept in log analysis and digital forensic. Super timeline provide comprehensive view of event across different system, device and application, allowing analysis to understand the sequence of event holistically. Okay, useful for investigation security incident involving multiple component system. Okay, data visualization. I don't know this screenshot where they took it from. Monitoring a reference, view log analysis. Okay, log monitoring and alert. Mini sim, like we use Splunk and Elastic, we always for I think look like Splunk this one, I'm not sure. External research and threat intel, of course, identify what may be interest to us, log analysis. That's why, for example, we search for IP address, file hashes, and domains for investigate. These other rooms that do these things. We analyze log file, we can search for the presence of threat intelligence. For example, this is an Apache access log. Okay, will tell us someone tried to access this. We can see that the IP address tried to access our site admin panel. Where is the admin panel here? This is a picture. TryHackMe, see TryHackMe design. Because you can see get request here. Oh, that got admin. Okay. What is the term for consolidated chronological view of logged event from diverse source? Diverse source, we talk about it, where is it? Super timelines, so let's go with that. Then what is, which thread intelligence indicator would this and this? This is the hash, let's see if we can know what TryHackMe want to say to us. Let's close this because I was playing around it. Oh, you can't detect it automatic. Okay, this is hash, so threat is basically this one, so it's file hashes. We come now to this labs later on, because that's the part. Now this is like in general, for example, engine X, you have access log there, error is there, Apache usually var log, Apache 2 access, you can see the pattern here, they all in var log, MySQL, they all in var log, they are the same structure, the name of the software, PHP also in var log, all Linux is in var log, so you can guess, you don't need to memorize anything, they all come in the same things. common pattern abnormal user behavior. This is more, you can read about this more, online multiple failed login attempt to detect things, unusual login time, geographic anomaly if your most of your client is local or your admin are local, if you see an IP outside, frequent password change, why someone went to change their password every time, unusual user agent string. This is also very important. This is a room in TryHackMe. What's the name of that? One of the last ones, common attack signator. Okay, SQL injection, you can see it when you see the input, like you know this, we always use them, union, all these things, you can see them like here. You can see it's trying to do an SQL injection. The cross, the JavaScript, you can see, for example, this will pop up. You can see he's injecting a script here inside. So there's more information, there's more rooms that path traversal file, so you can see, because when you try to get and you're trying to play around this, so you can see. Okay, what is the default file path to view logs regarding to Nginx? Nginx, you can see Nginx. A log entry containing this, you can see, you can play this. If you don't see it clearly, you can just pull down in you can see what he's doing here. This is LFI, so is what we've been doing it path traversal, because when you send it in encode the browser will encode it this way, but that's the original origin file. Try to access the PowerSafe environment. Now what's next one? Automated analysis. So we have advantage, disadvantage, of course, save time, but automated analysis tools are usually commercial only and sometimes they're very expensive, this automatic stuff. Manual is cheap but might not be, it is time consuming because you need to check by hand. Imagine like you have millions of logs, so a log file is processed by a tool which run an output. What form, if it's a tool, so it's an automated. An analysis open when analysis, so it's manual, so he's opening, doing it manual. So now the first one is no log analysis to command line. Okay, Apache. So log analysis. Log analysis of access file, so this is the file of ours, it's an Apache log, you can see it, let's play with it. Let me get my computer. I was playing with it now, so clear. Now let's cd log analysis. I can say, for example, cat apache, no, apache.log. Who is this? Oh, apache.log, cat apache.log. You can see it's a long file. Okay, there is less command that we can use. Less, you can do enter, and then you can slowly, or you do, and then when you press Q to log out. If I go now next one, what's the command? The tail command. Tail give you the last, I think, last five or last 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Same as head Apache log give you the first 10 and tail you the last 10. If we go now to okay, there is a tail minus F minus N 5, for example. The F, it's it mean if you, usually when you do a file is changing, like for example, like you if you waiting for the log to see it, you don't need to open every time. You can just alert it F, and it whatever it's new information will pick it up. So the minus F option, which allow you to follow the log file in real time. The minus N, it will tell you how many, how specific the number of lines. So this one is common Linux. Then the WC is a number of words, so you can say a number of lines in general. So it tell you, it give you all information, 70 line, I think the word and characters, the third one. Then the cat command, of course, cat. Now here's the game. Like for example, if this example, I didn't know this before, to be honest with you. Minus F1 Apache log, it gives us the IPs. And if we let me go back to head Apache log. So the idea is because there's space beneath them, so this is number one, this is number two, because they all have space. And you can see now it said to you F7 to extract the URL. So F7 is a URL. So where is the URL? Is this one? Why is it 7? IP is 1, so 2, 3, 1, 2, there's another space here, so there's 3, 4, 5, why is 7, how is counting? Okay, let's see, the first one IPs, what's the second one? The line. Third one, another line. The fourth, at the time. So if I want the URL, I go 7. Oh, it give me 7. Okay, we have another flag there, so. Then we have a sort. We can sort, of course, alphabetical order and all of that. So if we can cut minus D space minus F1, this is the IP. Then the pipe sort minus N. So you can always read about this there. So the above command, we pipe the output. So it's cut minus R is reverse order. Unique as it stand, it's unique minus R minus R get unique, so unique is reverse order. Oh, we can do that now, just minus, so I just see unique. So still a lot of IPs. You can also append minus C option to output unique lines. Unique minus C. Oh, the unique line prepare the count of occurrence for each line. Okay. Nice one. Okay. Set is also well known in Linux. So for example, give us this example. Let me copy it, see what happened. This is a replace. Let's see if it did really change it. Like July 31. Yeah, you can see it's a change it already. You see how the date is. The normal Apache is supposed to be this 31 July. Set is very powerful to replay to do the oak also is good. Now this is a good example. We need it later on. For example, oak $9, which greater or equal 400, we can use it now because damn it, where is the equal now? 400 Apache log, we got that. We can count them by WC. Okay, let's do now in this case $9 field, and for that we can go back to the one. The grep command is well known, so grep, we don't need a bracket there, I think. it give you the admin.php. Grep minus c, you can append minus c to the grep to count the entries machine. Let's see what happens if I put minus c. Oops. One. Minus n. What, I forgot what n do. We could add minus n option to help quickly locate. Oh, n is the line, the number line. So we can just say minus n, and it tell you it's number 37. Okay, minus v for reverse. For not. Let's practice now. Use a combination of the build command in apache.log file to return only the URLs. Remember we did this now, it's the cat command. F1 was doing, it was F9. No, let's see first before we do the content. Not 9, 9 is the status, so it's what, 7. Yeah, 7 is the URLs. User return the URLs. What is the flag that it is returned in one unique entries? Cat unique salt. Let's play around this. Where is my, let's try again. Let's say sort. Let's put unique. Okay, it gave us already the flag, so that's unique. You can play around it and it give us. Now the next question is, in the Apache log file, how many total? 200, we say, let's make sure we have them first. 200, we said 9. So 9, now I need to get, let me grab the 200, because that's what I'm looking for. Looking for how many HTTP 200. Then I need to, how many? So I need a WC conda line. So we have 52 lines. So we can get it in different way. We remember the other command is, this command, where is it? Okay. We can say, give me the 200 equal, so we can use oak here, number 9, 200 Apache log. We can get the same number, you see, 52 lines. So it's 52. The next question is, in the apache.log file, which IP address generate the most traffic? IP address, let's see how many, the count of the, let's make sure first, number one we know it's the IPs. How about sort them unique. No, unique minus, what's that number again? No, not n. Count them, c. What he said, useful command cat sort is, remember when we said the number, what that command again that gave me minus c? What minus c? Append minus c option to output a unique line and prepend the count of occurrence of each line. Okay, so if we look here, where is the biggest number? So it's this one, number 8. Number 8, the other is 6, so is this is the correct IP? It should be, because that's the, it means 8 times that IP. If it's an 8 times, so it must be the one that has the biggest traffic. What is the complete timestamp of the entry where it accessed the login.php? The hint will say that the time is just between bracket, we know that. So now what we need to, we can just grab something easy. We can grab login.php from Apache. I can do two grep or two cat. I can pipe it again, so it's not like pipe it again in another grep. Grep 10.10.122. So I don't need to write that. So it's 65.76. The timestamp, it's this one. Okay. The next one, log analysis to regular expression. Let me go to log analysis, regular expression. Okay. Regular expression. And it is a grep. No, we have a what's file we have now? cd regis. We have that file there. So if we grep to do regular expression, you need to add it minus e. Let's say if we post equal 1. So start with 1, then any digit from 0 to 9. From 0 to 9. In the Apache log, so basically that's what you get. We grep, this is the fixed line, so it's 1, all of them 1, then play the number from there. So that's regular expression minus e. There is also egrep, so you can use egrep directly. Regular expression for log passing, of course, regular expression is good skill to have, so it's not like this is the site they're referring to. I'm always on it now. Let me come back to this. Oh, this even I need to, because I was googling that, so we come back now. What I was doing in this one? Let me copy it, put it there, because I thought we need this later on. Let's see. So if we go to our log file here and put there a basic example, we want to promote IP address. This is the IP address. If we put this regular expression there, it will pick up the IP address. It's the good thing about this website, it's nice. You see, is a group one, the bracket, it mean group, 0 and then 3 times that, and then the 1. That's how you control the IP addresses. So yeah, 09 number from 1 to with IP address can, okay, then you also do forward slash 3, specify that the previous grouping group should be repeated. That's why you get 1, 2, 3, and then the last one. And then here is log scratch. This is a room from TryHackMe log scratch. You should look at that, because it uses these things like a regular expression. You need to, where is that room? Log scratch. This one. You should watch. Do this room. Here, just give you a quick introduction on it. What would you modify the origin grep pattern about to match a blog post with an ID between 22 and 26? 22 and 26. You see, we did this 22, 26, so we can do 22, 26. So it's 2. Start from 22 to 26. So we can have this. So what we do is just do this. Let's see if I correct. It should be. What is the name? Logstrash. This is a quick answer, but you need to look, as I said, you need to look to the room for more more information about this. That's the log room and the official good documentation. The next one is our friend that we always use is CyberChef. Everybody should know CyberChef. He has also that magic. It's automatic usually. When you detect it, it will show you here, so you don't need to add it in general. Of course, there is a regular expression to search on IPs. You can use this. Do they have an example to copy and paste? No. What file we have in the regular expression? Email and Apache. Oops. If I copy there, and I can use a regular expression, this one, I can just go regular expression and just put there and then say, for example, list match. I can get all the IPs. Nice. Okay, and then what's next? Uploading file. You can upload a file, so it's straightforward. And then let's try. Upload the log file name access.log. Where is my access.log? Where is access? You mean this? Use the list of IP address. What is the full IP address that start with 212? Okay, let's look also for sort. 212. Let's reverse it. 212. We got the IP. We're still using the file access.log, using the same file. Request was made in, is encoded in base64. What is the decoded value? Okay, because it's base64, you can guess, you can look for that little things equal, you can find it here, so you can search for it. So it's base64, always have that. So let me remove that. Why is not picking it up? Why the magic didn't work? Why is supposed to, he's supposed to detect it usually. Let's do the magic. What happened to magic? Okay. Matching ops from basic to valid DT8 for entropy for. So he needs, he think it's 85. Why? Because of this. Okay. Oops. Let's get base 64. So okay, we'll have that. The next question is, using CyberChef, decode the file name encode flag. Okay, copy it. Okay, so it's already base64, so you can see it's done. And use regular expression to extract. You know, these two ways to do this. These the lazy way, you just put MAC address here and put extract and you get the answer directly. So easy way. So it's not like it's cheating a little bit, but you can we can know it's correct one. Now if we want to do the regular expression, the one I copy it now, that's a regular expression for the MAC address. If I want do it in the hard way, I can just remove this This is look for regular expression. And that's the regular expression. List match, you can get that one, 08. And you can see here, we can pull it here. Let me take this file, copy, paste. You can see it's also detected here. 082E29. So you can use the ZK expression here. You can use it as I said, you can use the MAC. It has an option for MAC address. Extract MAC address is directly, you have it here. So we know this is the MAC address. Now this one is also a small introduction, but you can need to go to Sigma rooms for this. This is a room for Sigma. You guys read about it. This is also a small introduction to Sigma and Yara. What language does Sigma use? Sigma, of course, it's in YAML. It's a YAML syntax. This is just a small introduction. It's not like it teaches you Sigma here. What it used to denote the title in Sigma rule? If you look Sigma rule here, title is a title. You use title. That's what you use in Sigma rule. And what keyword is used to denote the name in Yara? Yara is also pattern. Yara is also a YAML format tool that information based on binary and textual patterns. So you need to do the rooms for this, otherwise you're not really understand it correctly, Yara here. What keyword is used to denote the name of the rule? Name of the rule. Name is rule, so that's you can see it's how to define the rule. This is just an introduction. You don't think it's give you a... And then we're done. Hope, guys, you enjoy. Hope I was able to explain. If you have any question, you can leave a comment, and thank you. And please like and share. It helps the channel. And then what you get, login legend. Thank you very much, and have a good day, everybody.